in the country at home tonight against a rebuilding, an improving, and can be a dangerous Texas Tech team. So we'll see if the Red Raiders can hang on the road. First possession of the night to Oklahoma.
We'll watch for Oklahoma. They're in a little dribble drive offense. They like to keep the floor spread, give their guards plenty of room to penetrate.
Showing off an outstanding shooting performance, the Sooners against Baylor. Buddy Hield shoots the first shot of the game and missed it. And a chance for Devontae Williams and Texas Tech to get a bucket in transition. Hield hustled back to get the defensive rebound. Hield in transition, commits an offensive foul.
Well, really, in that situation, Jordan Witter kind of gave the ball to Buddy Hield in a bad spot. They were both jammed up about 2 or 3 feet apart from each other. Good job by the Red Raiders getting back on defense, getting their feet set.
And it will be worth watching on Saturday in Waco in what turned out to be a really impressive Oklahoma win. Buddy Hield got 2 personal fouls in the first half, sat for the final 9 minutes of the half, so his minutes were limited early against Baylor.
And on this end of the floor for Texas Tech, watch this young man, number 11, Zach Smith. Kind of an up-and-comer in this conference, just a sophomore, can shoot that ball from the face-up, and one of the best athletes in the league.
A good example of that right there. Zach Smith may be their most talented player. He has the first basket of the game on either side.
I've been really impressed by Smith in the games that I've seen for the Red Raiders. Nearly 10 points a game, about 6.5 rebounds. Good shot blocker.
Jordan Woodard, who had 20 in the first half Saturday while Hield was in foul trouble. He has the first 2 for Oklahoma.
It's amazing the improvement that Jordan Woodard has had in his game, and it's almost, I feel like, a more of a comfortability factor. He was the point guard for this team last year. They switched spots with him and Cousins, and now he is lighting it up from behind the arc.
Matthew Temple, the big man, put the ball on the floor and draws a foul against young Kadeem Latin, who has really turned into maybe the best shot blocker in the Big 12, but that's a personal foul against Latin.
Well, Matthew Temple, he's a great story. He was friends with Clark Lammert, a former Red Raider player, and was playing some rec ball, and they discovered him, and he came and tried out this past summer, and Tubby Smith asked him to walk onto the team, and now he's in a starting role because Norentz Odiasse is out 4 to 6 weeks with a broken metatarsal in his right foot.
Well, Matthew Temple makes this first, misses the second. He does have championship experience. He and Delta Tau Delta won the rec league title at Texas Tech. And now he's starting for the varsity team in the Big 12. That is pretty amazing.
But he has some size and some smarts. The coaching staff really praised him, just said he's putting in the time and learning the game and learning the what they want from him on a night in and night out basis.
Isaiah Cousins had a good look but missed the jumper. Gocher pull up three, no good. Rebound tapped out and a nice one from Woodard, who then goes behind the back. Pulls up for three, too strong. That one is out of bounds and nobody has signaled yet. It's going to be Oklahoma basketball. Tubby Smith wondering exactly why the call went against his guys, but I think it was the right call.
Yeah, I think so. I think Spangler knocked it off of the Red Raider player.
Cousins. Part of Jordan Woodard's improvement has been Cousins' ability to take over the bulk of the point guard duties. That has really helped Oklahoma. There's Buddy Hield on the attack.
And that's what makes Buddy Hield so hard to guard and why he can get 25 and a half points per game. It's not just the three-point shooting. We know he makes 4 of those per game. But the improved ball handling and the ability to finish at the basket is one of the best things that he improved on over the summer.
It's part of the reason he came back, right, for his senior year.
Wanted to be more efficient on the offensive end and improve his ball handling, become more of a combo guard.
Smith down low, one dribble, right over top. Spangler missed the shot, gets his own miss, and there's Latin with the block and a tap out by Woodard. Cousins was thinking about hitting Hield. Nobody guarded him, so he just went to the free throw line and knocked down the shot.
Well, how about the timing of Kadeem Latin on the other end of the floor? I mean, Zach Smith is a tremendous athlete, and he was going to lay that up from about 5 feet with a soft touch, but Latin comes out of nowhere, and that leads to the transition opportunity.
Jumper for Temple. He banked it in.
Well, he'll take them any way that he can get them. 2 games ago, he scores 8 points and 4 rebounds at TCU.
You mentioned the injury to Odiasse, one of their better big men. So he's going to have to play a lot more minutes now. Tie game, Oklahoma ball. First few minutes of this game for the top-ranked team in the country. Ryan Spangler shoots a three. Too strong. Keenan Evans brings it up for Texas Tech.
Now, the two guys I feel that have to really get going for Texas Tech to pull off the upset tonight are their starting guards and two leading scorers, this young man, Devontae Williams, and Todrick Gocher.
Well, Williams had his shot altered by Latin, but there was Temple to put it back in.
Right now, Texas Tech seems a step ahead of Oklahoma in everything that they're doing, the offensive rebounds, the putbacks.
A little sluggish start for the Sooners. Heel down low. What a look to Woodard. Draws a foul. Great pass from Buddy Hield, so Jordan Woodard will shoot free throws. When we come back, the Sooners down two.
ESPN's exclusive presentation.